Hi, so today I'm going to share with you how you can sign up on the OKX Cryptocurrency Exchange. I'm going to share with you how you can set up your account, secure it, and be ready to start trading cryptocurrency step by step, even if you're a complete beginner and just getting started in cryptocurrency. If you do want to follow along, the link to the exchange will be in the description below. If you do, once again, have any questions, always feel free to let me know in the comments below. Let's get straight to it. So the first step is you need to be on the OKX Cryptocurrency Exchange website, which if you don't already know, I will leave a link in description, like I said, for you if you do want to sign up using my link. First up, you need to come to the website like I mentioned. Feel free to read and do whatever you like. But if you want to get started, all you do is go to the top right here where it says sign up. You see this little button right here? Just click on that. Once you click on that, it'll just take you to a page where it just asks you your country, where you live pretty much. You can pretty much just type it in here if you wish. So just click on it, click on this, and the drop down will come up. All you do is type in the country. I'm in Australia. But you can put any country that you wish. Now you can read the terms of service and privacy policy here. It's totally up to you. Understand what's going on. So I'm just going to click on I agree. Then next step is you click on next. You just want to make sure you're confirming that you're doing the correct country, because you do need to show proof of identification. So it's just making sure that you are in the country that you say you are, because you have to confirm your ID. All right. So now you just need to make sure you put your email address here, the one that you want to sign up on. Then you can put a referral code if you wish. Now, this is my code here. If you wish to use my code, feel free to use it. It's 65328393. Totally up to you. It might have some sort of benefit. I don't know. It's optional. So the next step is you put an email address in. So all you do is type in an email address. So correct. Otherwise, you won't be able to do anything. You need to have an actual real email address signed up. Then once you're ready, just click on sign up. And then you just follow along with the steps. Now it's going to ask you to send them a code. Get a code from your email address. This will verify your email address. And it'll be one layer of security for your account. So this is what the code will look like in your email address. So all you will get is an email, and it will say sign up email code. And then this is what the code will be. Now you're just confirming the code. So all you do is copy and paste the code, or you can type it in. It's totally up to you. So go back to where you were signing up before and just paste the code into here, just like that. And now your email should be verified. So you should, OKX will verify your account, your email address. Next step is you put a phone number in here, which is really straightforward. If you want to do that, just put your phone number in here. If you're a different area code, you can always click this drop down tab here. But it automatically, depending on your country that you chose, it'll put your area code here, your number code here. All right, so as you can see, I've put my phone number in. So once you're ready, just click on verify now. So all it will do is send you a code, and you just confirm the code. So 78, it should just be messaged to you. If it doesn't, just resend the code. And there you go. As you can see, I just typed in the code that was sent to my email, and then it's complete. Now this is just asking for a password. So feel free to use whatever password you wish. But just make sure you follow these rules here. They give you an example of these, as you can see right next to it, as you can see. So just make sure you do that. And then once you're done, just click on next. And now if you want to make it visible, your password, you can also click on this little eye here. Once you're ready, just click on next. And your account should be set up. So now the next step is you need to verify your account. So you need to prove that you are who you say you are. So you want to prove that you are the person that signed up on your account. If we want to trade on the platform, we do have to verify identification to prove who we are, who we signed up is. So the next step is you want to click on verify now. Now you want to click on the which one that you are verifying for. So if you're just a single person individual, this is the one you want to click on, which is majority of people. Then you need to sign up here. So someone that would like manages people's money. But most of us is going to be individual verification. So then click on continue. So click on verification. Now you need to provide ID and selfie verification and personal information. So ID and selfie. So you can use your phone for this. That's what I recommend. If anyone wants to verify, just use your mobile phone. This is its most simple way. So once you're ready, just click on verify ID. Now you can click on the region, change the region here if you want, but everyone that signed up, whatever you signed up your account on, Australia, US, it should be here automatic. Then you can click on the ID type. So just click on the drop down tab right here. You can do passport, proof of ID. Now they recommend driver's license or passport. I would say those are the two easiest ones. So I'd say driver's license. Most people will have that. Then click on next. Now what you can do is get your phone, and all you do is get to the camera app, and all you do is scan the QR code. barcode and it should appear. Now, you can also do this on the mobile browser as well. So let's copy this. All right, I'm going to show you what the app looks like here. So as you can see right there, that's what it looks like when you do go onto your phone. I don't know if you can read that. So all it does is you're just making an image of your identification, the front and the back. Make sure it's not blurry. Make sure it's not cropped or anything. So once you're ready, you just click on start verification, allow camera. So as you can see right there, if you can see what they're doing, so just front side of the driver's license, take a photo of it, and I will go and do that. Now it's asking for the back side of my license. So all I do once again is take a picture of my license and the back of it. And then once you've done that, you need to take the selfie, which is the easy part. So now all it's asking me is, are you ready to take a selfie? So all I have to do now is take a selfie image and the verification step is completed. So once you're ready, you just click on the next button right at the bottom here. So I'm gonna click on next. And then all I do now is face the camera in front of me and move it closer. You have to move the camera up pretty close, as you can see what I'm doing with my phone. And now I hold still and it scans my face here. And now it's verifying the image, as you can see right here. It's verifying. And as you can see, submitted the identification. I have completed it. Now it will just review it. So once you have done your verification, it should say, as you can see right here, submitted. And then once you go back to your homepage, as you can see, it's saying reviewing. It will take up to 2 minutes to review your identification. But just come back when it's in a couple of minutes and it should be complete. All right. So once you have verified your account and it has been verified, you can now deposit cryptocurrency and start trading on the platform. Now, before you do anything, you need to make sure you set up security on your account. This is the next step, to make sure you have your account secured as much as you wish. You can do as much as you like. It's totally up to you. So all you need to do is come to the top right here and you will see a down tab. On the drop down tab, you'll see a tab that says security. Now they do have some recommendations here for you. So pass keys, they recommend to use that. Phone authentication, so use your get codes by SMS and WhatsApp or calls for login and other functions. So I would suggest to set up this one and suggest to set up the authenticator app. We already have the email authentication and the password set up. Now you can come down here and freeze your account temporarily if you wish. If you want to freeze your account, if you think you're not going to use it for many months or something like that, feel free to do this. Now if you do freeze your account, you will have to provide your identification again and fill out a form on their website. You can also close your account. It is permanent if you do close your account, by the way. So I will recommend these two right here. Set up your authentication app. So just click on the setup button right here. Now all you need to do is grab your phone. Once again, grab your phone. You need to download the Google authentication app. Now I'm going to show you what the Google authentication app looks like. So I'm going to go full face cam. So this is what the Google authentication app looks like. It is the one on the left, if you can see. So it's this app right here. Whoops. It's this one right here, that one. So you can download it on the App Store. All you do is go on the App Store and type in Google Authentication app right there. And you can see the app, as you can see right here. And it'll come up saying download it if you haven't got it already. So just download it. The button to download it would be right there. The download button would be right here. Sorry, I have to remember it's inverted. The download button would be right there. You'd click that. I already have the app. So all it does is show up here. You can also just scan it. So you can just scan the QR code with your phone and automatically take you to the App Store to download the app as well. But you already I've already done this. So we're going to click on next. Now you can scan the code or manually enter the code. So I'm just going to scan the code here. So if you look at the App Store right here, mine has a lot of codes already, as you can see. Yours will probably be empty. But if you see the bottom here, this little plus symbol, just click on that. It comes up with a prompt saying scan or put the code in. So you can manually put the code in. As you can see, enter a setup code or scan the QR code. Now, the easiest way is to do the scan. Then once you're on here, you just click on scan the code. I'm gonna scan it real quick. And then, so once you do scan it, at the very bottom here, if you can see at the very bottom, that is the code there. And it changes every single 30 seconds. That's why I don't mind showing you these codes, because it changes every 30 seconds. As you can see, it's changing as we speak. So you need to get that code. Once we click on next here, it asks us for an email. So confirm your email again, the one that you signed up with your account on the OKX exchange. So just click on send the code. And as you can see, this is a code right here. This is a code that you need to go back to the website. It should be sent to your email address. Put that in there. Now, this is the code that I mentioned before at the very bottom of the app. So just type that in. It should be a 6-digit code. And then once you're ready, just click on confirm. And then your Google authentication should be set up, as you can see right here. It has been set up. up. Now, the next one you can do is the phone verification. So set up the phone verification. All you do is put in your phone number once again, the one that you put in earlier, and then you send the code to the phone. You also get an email again. Do the email thing again, like you did just before. And then the authenticator app, the code that I put in before, the Google Authenticator code. So let's start this off. First, we put our phone number in. All right, so as you can see, it verifies my phone number now. So I'm just verifying my phone number here. So all I've done is put the code in that was sent to my mobile number right here. And now I got to do the Google Authentication app as well. So you can just get the code, the one that you did just before, and then once you've done that, you just go and confirm it and it should link up your mobile number. Done. All right. So as you can see, we have linked up the phone verification and we've done the Google app authentication. In my opinion, these are probably all you really need to do. Now, if you want to do these other ones here or want a guide on how to set them up, feel free to let me know in the comments below. I will happily do that. But this is, in my opinion, this is all you really need to do. You're secured your account. If you want to secure it way more, you can feel free to set up these. But now you should be ready to trade on the OKX platform. Now, if you do want a guide on how to buy cryptocurrency or anything else, feel free to let me know in the comments below. I hope this video has helped you out. So now you're ready to trade on the OKX cryptocurrency exchange. You should have your account set up. You should have signed up. You should have verified your identification and you should have set up security, which is the main things that you need to do to be able to trade on the OKX cryptocurrency exchange. If you do want to sign up with my link, once again, I will leave the link in the description of this video. If you do have any other questions at all, feel free to let me know in the comments below. I really appreciate you watching this video. Thanks, and I'll see you next time. See you guys. See you later.